Ladies and gentlemen, it's good to see you. How are you? It's been some time, has it not? Why is the... Hold on, we need better music than this. Give me like 10 seconds. Poopy music. I can't believe it. I can't start a stream like this. Yeah, Halo Reach. That's what I'm talking about. All right, we're back in action. I tip my fedora to my fellow gamers. Gamers, how are you? Welcome to the modding stream. All right. How's it going, everybody? It's good to see you. Hope you're doing well. I'm just relaxing here, having a grand old time on Ultimate Forge. Can you believe this? Do you see what we're on right now? I'm on a forge piece. That wall behind me, that's a forge piece too. Do you remember this? Turns out, you guys might not remember this, but this mod is about forging your own maps. It's not about corvettes and glassing beams and... Well, it is about Mogus. I was gonna say it's not, but it definitely is. You know, there's some trees over there. You can see they're casting shadows now. Look, I made the trees cast shadows. That's called depth. Yeah, so today's stream is going to be a little bit less about making giant spaceships. Although, you know, I'm not going to count it out. I mean, who knows what's going to happen? The night is young. But, you know, it's going to be mostly about getting this map good. I want this map to be good. You know why I want it to be good? For your sake. We're going to get this map looking good so I can put out Alpha 0.4 so you can play. And it's going to be fantastic, isn't it? It's just going to be the best. I can already smell it now. Pose. I mean, the map... fun. I mean, fun. I can smell the fun we're all going to have when we play this together. All right. With that being said, there's somebody I'd like to introduce you to. Sweetie. Sweetie. Hold on, I got it. Where are you? Why can't I move? It's like I'm disabled. Sweetie, would you like to introduce yourself? Oh, geez, she's shy. Let me... Exiting. All right. Look, it's my wife, gamers. This is my Halo wife. Her name's, Waymer. Yep, that's her name. Isn't she so hot? She's my gamer wife. Look, you know she's a gamer because she has cat ears. That's how you know. She probably has a gaming chair like this one, except it's pink. And she has the cat ears. This is my wife. Please be kind to- Guys, please, you're being mean to her in the chat. What the fuck? Respect my wife. This is disgusting. Why would you act like this? You're saying, dear Christ, why? What is it? What do you mean? It's my wife. Have I not explained it enough to you? You guys, you just don't get it. I swear. She's a gamer. She has cat ears. They shouldn't have gave us tools. Oh, fuck. Stop flipping! I'm fine. I didn't get mad at that. But today's stream is about Forge. And remembering that this isn't just a mod where I make spaceships with cool glassing beams. It's a mod about making cool Forge maps and playing with your friends. Center of mass edit much- SHUT UP DAD! YOU DON'T KNOW WHAT YOU'RE TALKING ABOUT! I don't know- You don't know what you're talking about. You're crazy. You got a lovely wife shotgun. I'm surprised you got a good taste in women. What is that supposed to mean? What do you mean you're surprised I have a good taste in women? What? Why are you surprised? Have I given you the vibe that I'm like some kind of disgusting neckbearded like basement dweller that you're shocked that my taste in women is good? Why would you phrase it like that? Voice modder, she's not real. Fuck, not gonna add voice lines for her. I don't wanna. Yeah, she's got cat ears. I'll give her pink gaming chair so you know that she's a gamer. This is my waifu. Can we get a closer look at the Among Us? They got stuck halfway between venting. So sad. Can we get F in the chat for Mogus? Thank you. Can you show the sounds, please? Oh my god. Yeah, I'll show the sounds, okay? Jeez, calm down. Oh, I fixed it. Before I get in to show you the cool stuff, I finally fixed a bug that was plaguing me forever. So, if you've ever played any of my mods, you might know that you can never get into a vehicle right. Like, if you go up to the driver's seat, it'll say get in the vehicle, but you never can. I finally fixed that bug. So now, whenever you go to a driver's seat of a vehicle and it says, hey, get the fuck in, you can get the fuck in. You should update the gamer chair to have a bubble shield and let you fire the monitor beam from your outstretched hand like a buff version of Palpatine. Huh. Where's your face cam? Oh, you're right! I almost forgot. Hey, it's me. How you guys doing today? Hope you're having a splendid time. I'm drinking my coffee. Oh, we gotta put out, before we get any further into the stream, right? Before we get into all the cool shit and we start working, gotta put out a Discord notification. Discord notification. I was putting into announcements. Let's say, let me grab the Discord link or the stream link. What should I put? How about copy link? How about we say something like, No. It's not about me. It's about the stream. This is gonna be a notification. Incredible God Gamer can't be stopped. Parentheses, impossible. There we go. See, that's, you know, I'm gonna change the title of the stream to that too. Hold on, let me edit stream. Right now it says the sound update is here. Boring. God mod gamer can't be stopped. Ah, now we're talking. That's a title. God damn, is that a title. Sheesh. All right. You guys want to see something cool? Check this out. Where's my clobdor? My clover. Condor. All right, there we go. Check this out. So I had Green send me over the sound files from Halo Wars 2, and I did a little bit of witchcraft, a little bit of shenanigans with them, and I put them over here. Listen to that. Hold on, let me turn that. I'm gonna pause the soundtrack. Listen to this. Pretty cool, right? Condor's got sounds now. I love that. Honestly, it sounds so good. Like, it's not very Halo-y, it just sounds like a jet engine, but I like it. But you're probably sitting there, you're like, damn, that sounds, oh, so good. And I mean, like, I completely understand. But there's more. Add a siren to the police hog next? Yo, true, I didn't even think about that. God, my nose is running today. Alright. I gotta show you this, but to show you it, I gotta make an edit really quickly to the seat on it so I can get into it from a distance. Close. It's under vehicles, Corvette, vehicle. Cone up with the $2! Landing gear sound effect when? That's a good question. I don't know if I can do landing gear sound effects now that the landing gear is like dynamic and it like opens when you get close to the ground. I wonder if it's even possible anymore. All right, anyway. Check this out. It's gonna be spooky. I tested this in multiplayer with Green the other day, and it was so, like, crazy sounding. Well, let me get as far away as I can. Alright. I'm just not gonna say anything, okay? I'm not gonna say anything, I'm just gonna let you listen. Turn your volume up, and you might enjoy it. Just gonna fly away for a second, okay? Just to get it nice and quiet. Alright, now we're gonna turn around. Just gonna turn around, wait for it. So this could be you. Your friend could pop into the driver's seat of the Corvette in your multiplayer match. You know, you're in the battle, you're not really paying attention to the sky above you. Like, why would you, right? But then you hear this. You look in the distance, you see the Corvette. And you hear this. Good. Isn't it just good? That is the actual sound effect, by the way, of the Corvettes and Cruisers from Reach. Bless me. I was redoing this weapon because I was testing the glassing beam in multiplayer and it didn't sync, but Green and I kept testing, we found a way to make it sync, but I accidentally screwed up some of the effects on it, their placement, I mean, so it doesn't look perfect right now, but so you know, you will be able to do this in multiplayer. I feel better now, I just had to do that. Oh yeah, this is where you pilot the Condor right now as well. Right here, find this little plasma rifle. Come on over here. Oh, yeah, sorry, I did miss a dono. I missed two donos, my bad. Andrew! Vangdolst! It's good to see you. Welcome to the stream. Appreciate the $2. Much, I tell you, $2 to use. What the heck is that a mongoose doing on the thumbnail? Well, if you really want to know, and you might not believe me when I say this, and this might be a little unexpected, but he was being a little sus. Gabe the Babe with the fiver. Thank you very much, Gabe. Appreciate that. Have you ever thought about editing the skybox and lighting of ODST to look blue, like the promo art, as well as adding improved rain, like on the cover? You know, I had not thought of that, but it would be kind of fun, wouldn't it, to like make an ODST mission that mimicked like the first reveal trailer where it's like dark and blue and raining and you hear the music and there's like phantoms of searchlights and there's rubble everywhere. That would be really cool. Maybe that's the move. Demon, a song with the $5. Thank you very much, Demon. Good to see you as always. Have you heard of the tragedy of Darth Glossingbeam the Wise? You should just write, you know what you should do, Demon, is write things out as if it were read in a British accent, like phonetically. So instead of glassing beam, it's like glossing beam. Darth Glossingbeam the Wise. Thank you very much, though. Appreciate those super chats already, you guys. Oh, by the way, like, people, I know this is weird, and it should be backwards. Like, I should be selling you on these things, but people have literally been asking me a lot about channel memberships and, like, perks and stuff. I have them in the process. It might be as soon as tomorrow that I will have channel memberships set up. So you guys will have cool badges, and I'll put custom emotes and stuff in the chat. It'll be epic. It'll be epic. So if you actually were interested in that, and you'd come to these streams a lot, which I know a lot of you do, then, you know, that's pretty cool. If you want to, like, support me that way and, like, get cool recognition in chat, then, you know, it'll be pretty sick. Can you actually add at least a hangar landing pad from Reach here? That would be kind of cool. Demon with the $2. Thank you very much. You said, why would I do that? I'm not British. Well, it sounds like you are. I read your super chat and it was British, so I don't understand. Are you lying? I don't get it. I don't know. It's so weird. Oh, look at that water. Look at that water. It's some nice water. I like that water right there. That's a good, you know, it's a forge piece, that water there. What? I love that people just switching the D in Demon and S with in song to around and calling you Semen of Dawn. It's really unfortunate that just switching those two letters sounds really funny. Oh, let me put the music back on. Sorry. Let's get that. Those Halo vibes back in the stream. Yeah, yeah, yeah. All right. So here's what I want to do today. I made this little area, this big area here, and I made this smaller area here. We added a couple of structures around. I want to finish up the map today, my gamers. I'm tired of this map not being finished. The sooner I finish this map, or finish the map, you know what I mean, the sooner I can put out a version of this that we can all play, and then we can do the infection game mode that I've been thinking about for like a week, where there's one alpha zombie piloting the Corvette, everyone else is on a blank map, riding around in the golden warthogs with speed, and the alpha zombie's literally just trying to glass everybody. So, there you go. That's gonna be the first game mode we play on stream with this map once I release it. So let's get this map built so people can start building their own maps. Demon of Song with the $5! I'm Irish. You right, Gammy Blighter. There's no way I'd want to be like those tea drinkers. Whoa! You said you're Irish, but you still sound British. I literally don't understand. What are you trying to imply here, Demon? Because you're still sounding pretty British, if you're asking me. Zinni Ombine with the $5. Wouldn't Juggernaut be a better choice for that kind of game mode? Yeah, honestly, yeah, it would. Can you do One Life Juggernaut? I don't play Juggernaut enough to know. But yeah, I think actually that's a great idea. I think that's a fantastic idea. And I would like to do that. But let me open up Blender. We're gonna work on this map, okay? It's gonna be sick. It's gonna be wicked, sick, nasty. Sicked, wick, nasty. What? Oh, I didn't mean to get in this. Oh well, I guess now that I'm in it, I have no choice but to activate the glassing beam. Ah. God, it's so fucking cool. James Turner, thank you for the $2. Much appreciated. Love your work, Mr. Shadig. Thank you, James. Appreciate you. Speaking of which, James, you reminded me of something I haven't done in quite a while, which I will now proceed to do. Which is to spawn in something that you basically had created by talking about it and putting it in my head. You lived in my head rent-free for so long that I ended up making it myself. And that's what I'm talking about, the Super Mantis baby! Alright, here's what I need to do for the Super Mantis. I need to give it sounds, and I need to give it weapons, and I need to fix its animations. And then this thing will be so sick to have in a multiplayer.
Eh.
Turbo Simp with the $2, thank you. Seaman of Dong with the fiver. And then actually Demon of Song with the fiver. Thank you very much, Demon. I guess I'm just gonna stop these for the night then, since my heritage is not being respected. Oh fuck, I forgot to read it in the accent. Whatever. Since my heritage is not being respected. By the way, how much for you to stream VR chat? How much to stream VR chat? Ooh, that's a good question. Considering that VR chat will be perceived as intense cringe to anybody who doesn't understand it or isn't like a giant weeb. Ooh, that's a steep one. Because I like VR chat, that's why I hang out with friends on there all the time, but that's just because I'm a giant nerd. And I'm totally okay with being cringe. As far as everyone on the stream, I don't know if I could bring myself to play VR chat on stream and just be so blatantly open about not giving a fuck. That's a tough one. I'll have to think it over. Can we see your wife one more time before you begin actual work on the map? Did I just crash the game? I just crashed Sapien. What the? I was gonna say yes. Oh, I gotta open the map anyway, so sure. I'll show you. VR chat, very good. I spotted you a mile away. Okay. Listen, alright. Just because I'm a giant weeb and I'm a VR enthusiast, you don't know anything about me. You don't know anything about me. That's all I'm saying. Hyper, thank you for the $2. British chair. Let me see. Demon of Song, thank you for the $5. You make it not cringe, though. Make people think it's not cringe. You might be onto something here. You might be onto something. I suppose I could do my best to make it not cringe. So instead of, like, showing everyone my collection of cringe avatars, I could wear my cool Halo Infinite Spartan avatar that I spent way too much time on. And then I could just be a Spartan the whole stream. And then I could just hang out with some homies and play some minigames in VR. That might be fun. Yeah, that'd be a good time. I think even Green's got a VR headset too. I'm gonna invite him on. It would still be risk though. Plus, I have friends who would probably get me banned off of YouTube just due to their avatars alone. We'll see though. I don't know. I'll think about it. I don't know how much that would be. But Gabe the Babe, thank you for the fiver. If you bring cringe to the class, you have to share it with everyone. Maybe I will. Maybe I just might. We gotta spread our wings and fly away. We can't stick to only Halo forever. People have to know that my life isn't only Halo, it's just mostly Halo. Alright, somebody asked to see my wife one more time. Here she is. She's beautiful, isn't she? She's like Master Chief, but with cat ears and boob armor and cool Halo's theme stuff and a butter. So overall, she is indeed my... Can I shoot her? I don't remember. She has shields. That's sick. I don't even remember adding those. What the fuck? Wait, why did it do that? What the fuck? Wait, let me do that again. What the fuck? Yeah, I don't know. Doesn't make no sense. Demon of Song with the $5! How much you want to bet I can make this map into a VR chat world? I mean, this map would be pretty easy, honestly. This map would realistically be pretty easy. It's so simple. I could just send you the Blender file, but it's not even done. It ain't even done. Can you mod it so she's a playable character? Well, I was messing around, so the story behind why I have random cat whammon Master Chief is this is actually related to VR chat. Somebody sent me this model like ages ago, and I was like, oh, that's cool. I like the model. And I was like, oh, it's kind of Halo themed. What if I ported it into Halo just for shits and giggles? And I tried that like months ago. I was bored, and I like got halfway to the porting process, never put her in game. I basically had her at the step where I almost had put this model in game, but I never did. And then I got bored the other day, and I was like, I'm just gonna finish it up. And so I did, and I ported it, and it worked. It looks pretty good. Whoa, didn't mean to zoom in there. But, you know, it's just for you guys in chat. But for real, I didn't, it took a while, and then I was like, but now I don't care anymore. The reason she's T-posing is because even though I did the skeleton, like, perfectly, it don't even work. So, no animations. And most importantly, though, it's not my Halo wife. It's blasting me. My real love. Don't tell my wife, though. My Halo wife, that is. Lovely weather we're having. Oh my god, I'm gonna die. Ugh! Alright, let's get to work on the map. Let's talk about this, right? We gotta talk about this map. So, let me off-screen open it up. Get it opened. Okay. Gonna go do a... you know, look at the... What the fuck is... is this it? Okay, yeah, this is it. Here's the map! This is the map we've been playing on all this time. Does it look familiar? It should. It should definitely look familiar. Did you just glass your wife? Listen, it didn't. It's not what it looked like, okay? Glass your wife. I hate my wife. Ooh, I hate my wife. Ooh, I guess I'll glass her. I'd love nothing more than to reduce her and the entire neighborhood into a molten glass plane. I hate my wife. Am I right, boys? Alright. Let me think here. So, alright, so here's the only plans I have set in stone, is this is gonna be the silent cartographer, or like, kinda like the silent cartographer, right? Like, this is like the based on a true story silent cartographer, you know what I mean? Like, it's exaggerated and it's not quite right, but it's like, you see the similarities, there are resemblances. And then I wanted to put like mountains over here. Like right now it's hills. It's like, you don't really notice it from a distance, but it does have like a bunch of little hills and stuff. So I'm not entirely sure if I'm going to put mountains there yet, but I think what I will do is I'll put like one big, no, I'm going to keep this open, right? This side of the map's going to stay open. Sorry to be that guy, but heavy Corvettes don't have glassing beams. Oh yeah, King of the Kings? Then explain this. Checkmate, atheist. That's a glassing beam on a Corvette right there. That's all I'm saying. Wait, I got distracted. So I gotta put mountains. Ultimate Forge really needs more team-based vehicles. Oh, don't worry. The Shadow is coming in. Maybe the Spectre. The Revenant's definitely coming in. And there's a new vehicle from one of the mobile games that Green showed me, and then I started porting over. I can actually show you it. I was working on this. Let me find it real quick. The Kestrel. The Kestrel has a lot of different iterations throughout Halo history, but this one was actually in a mobile game, and I upscaled, up-resed it, made some normal maps, edited the model a bit. It still needs some more work, but I was planning on, like, messing around with this and turning it in. It's basically the UNSC equivalent of a ghost, and I was planning on adding it into the map pretty soon. I just need to get it, like, touched up. The model itself needs a little bit more work than I was going to port it into game. So, here's a new vehicle coming pretty soon. It's kind of cool. Human Ghost, the Kestrel. Ooh! Ah, I can't sneeze! Ah, I'm fine. You plan on making Ultimate Forge playable for us again, seeing the shaders problem? Yeah, so right now, that's why I was working just a minute ago, right now actually, on getting this done. I want to get this map looking pretty good. Then once I do, I can add a couple more things to the Forge menu, put out a new version, we can do some play tests on stream, have a good time, and it'll be pretty fun. So, yeah, the sooner I do this and actually get some work done on it, the better. So that being said, let's map this out, okay? We've got a really cool mountain complex here, a nice smaller one over here, a little hill here, and of course at some point I want to do a giant underground cave system on this map, but that being said, it's more important that I think I add some more variety to the terrain. So can I get some feedback? Oh, tree clusters, yes, Slig. I was actually gonna, I'm very tempted to do that on stream today, actually. It'll go a long way towards adding detail to Forge Up. You know what? I'm gonna read this and I'm gonna say what I was gonna say. It Just Works Podcast, good to see you. Thank you very much for the $2. Appreciate you. Is there a chance for a Flood High charity map? I wonder if it still works. I don't know if I've showed this on stream before. Where did I save it as? I save it as High Charity New? Is there a multi? HC Old Test. There you are. Which one's newer? I will answer your question with this following presentation. It just works. Canyon following the river? Ooh, that's a good idea. Would you consider adding some kind of ravine to the map? Yeah, sure. Ravine would be cool. So you said, would I ever consider... Oh my god. Calm down, Scrub. Would I ever consider a high charity flood map? This is one of my first maps I ever made. It's not very good compared to what I can do now anyway, but it is a... I was going to use it for visuals on a video I never made for High Charity's boss fight that was cut from Halo 3 with the Gravemind and the Scarab that like Cortana like drives on out of this place. And basically, yeah, it's just it's a destroyed Scarab, and it's, you know, in a big floody arena with chunks and things all on the walls, and then the you know, you got Gravemind. Oh, and there's a bunch of flood too. And they fight you. Pretty cool. Did I miss a super chat? Oh my god, you did. I did miss a super chat. Sorry about that. Gabe the Bay, thank you for the $2. Rejected. I will pay you big money to add a lake. Honestly, that's not a bad idea. That's actually a pretty good idea, all things considered. Where would a good lake spot be? Maybe this corner over here? Because as much as it's cool that I added water planes, like realistically, a lake would be pretty nice to have like shorelines and such. Did you put an interior to the Corvette? If it's possible to cut the level from Reach on this, maybe one day. Whenever Reach Tools comes out, I'll consider it more because it'll be less work. Yeah, let me see here. Where's a good spot for a lake? If I theoretically just made like a small lake like that, right? I mean, that's pretty huge, actually. That's like a massively enormous lake. Let me open up the Alpine Sandbar, or sorry, Ultimate Forge again, because I want to know like how this lake might be way too big. Lake joins up with the caves underwater. Oh, that would be cool. Like the bottom of the lake has like a hole that goes into the caves. That would be really cool. Yeah, look at that, it's a lake. We got a lake. Obviously I needed to touch it up, but like, it's a lake. Oh, let me hide this guy, there we go. That's so huge though, let me look in game. Like how, I need to know like specifically how enormous I just made this lake. It's the size of this entire island. I don't know if I should make it that big. Maybe that's, might be a little ridiculous. Because at that scale, the lake would be like that entire corner of the map over here. And that's pretty huge. I thought about making boat vehicles. It's not really, to be honest. Yeah, this would be an enormous lake. Like, it would just be huge. It'd be like a mini ocean. It'd be like bigger than any Halo 3 multiplayer map. And it would just be pure water. If they upped the player cap to like 50, then it would be way more team-based vehicles. You know what, actually? You know what? I think this lake is actually a great idea, because having this means that you could make fully water. It's like this area is enormous, right? Don't get me wrong. This lake is huge, but at the same time, hold on, let me turn off water physics. Oh, wait. At the same time, this lake is also very nice because it's basically a sandboxy area where you can build maps with water on the bottom. That's essentially what it is. And that's pretty nice. I like that. Skaboodly-doo! Thank you very much for the fiver. Appreciate you. Yo, if you want, I could model some Covey City buildings real quick if you ever want to get the High Charity flood map up to snuff. Covey City building. That'd be sick. Why not? I mean, I can't promise I'll do it anytime soon because I'm always so busy working on other projects, but just having those assets at the ready would be way more motivating. So, I mean, I can't, like I said, I can't promise anything, but shit, that would be really cool to see at the very least. Delta Halo map? I love the aesthetic of Delta Halo so much. I would love, like seriously, love to make a Delta Halo style map in Halo 3. Just like the ancient ruined buildings aesthetic is so cool to me. This is such a terrible way to do things. I know, calm down, please, trust me, I know. I understand. But it will look better once the map is refined further on. We're not at that stage yet. Calm down, please, please, please just calm down, you're frightening me. Oops. All right, there's our makeshift lake. Actually, I really hate how that looks. Oh no, it's just because of the, that'll be auto-fixed. Alright, so here's our little lake, right? Pretty epic. I'll save this as a new file, just so we have a lake and no lake version. There you go, not bad. I'm actually gonna switch face orientation back on. Looks nicer when everything's blue. Gabe the Babe with the $2! Mazaferno said they have a sailboat in chat. Mazaferno? Are you the one making... The pirate mod? Is that you, Maza? Raise the elevation of the land around the edge of the lake and turn it into a flooded impact crater. That's a cool idea, but I think I'm going to leave it like this only because this is going to allow it to be more open, more sandboxy, and simple. So now there is an entire lake, right? Now there's an entire lake that you can use as a place to build water-themed maps. And you won't have to do it like on the edge of the map. It's literally just like in a reasonable place. It's pretty cool. What else? We've got a lake. That's pretty nice. Like to see it. Maybe I should do a canyon. One that like dips into the ground. Let's see, you're the pirate guy? Okay, yeah, that's sick. I'd love to know how you did that. Like if it's possible to utilize that in a more traditional sense of just having like vehicles like that. That sounds super cool. King of Kings, thank you for the fiver. Much appreciated. Thank you. Is it maybe possible to make the flame hog using the flame mortar, kind of like the wraith, but it leaves fire on the ground for a while? I mean, you could just do it like the straight up flamethrower weapon that exists already in Halo 3. You just like repurpose it, give it some more enhanced effects, make it shoot further, give a thick fire stream that just bursts out. Actually, I have a really good effect that would look nice for fire, now that I think about it. Maybe I'll do a flame hog at some point. It would be really nice. I'll just like turn the damage down on the fire. It's like super OP most of the time. You wanted a flamethrower warthog for a while and just never made it. Look, you know what, Green? I want to make the flame hog, not because like it's like hard or a challenge, but because I really want to do flamethrower effects for the flame hog. I think it would be so cool to have flamethrower effects on it. And besides, like, more warthog variants would be nice. Like, everyone's like, oh, you have the chain gun hog, you have the goss hog, and you have the missile hog. That's all it's ever been. Flame hog would be really sick. Everyone's always like, oh, do the Halo Halo 1 PC gearbox combat, or I mean rocket hog, which is also cool. But flame hog? Demon, thank you for the $2. The flame hog is from Halo Wars 2. Yeah, so technically it's canon, and that's fine. And also the Nightingale is really good too. Thank you for that fiver as well. Nightingale. Halo Nightingale. What is the Nightingale? I put Nightinglate. Oh, the Nightingale. It's like the thick transport falcon. Yeah. Somebody was making that recently. It was pretty sick. All right. I think we need an aircraft carrier, even if it isn't drivable. Yeah, one as a scenery piece would be really nice. I feel like I got a DM recently from somebody about the aircraft carrier, but I can't remember because I have shit memory. I don't know. In any case, I like these hills here. They're kind of nice. Maybe I'll leave... I don't want to leave this whole place just hills. I was thinking about adding something in the center here. But I don't know. I don't know. All right, can I get some suggestions here? Because frankly, I'm not very good when it comes to this kind of thing. If somebody could tell me, like, I think you should add XYZ for the terrain. Like a mountain, a canyon, a hill, something. The only thing right now I have set in my mind is for sure doing the... This squinky doink right here, you know what I'm saying? Laser hog. Ooh, laser hog might be cool. like a weaker laser, though. It Just Works Podcast, thank you for the $2! Oh man. Anything from Halo Wars 1 and 2 is chef's kiss drools. Yeah, I agree. They're really nice. Cliffs and ravines, caves and ravines, ocean cliffside. Making the long canyon there deep enough to make flying circuits. Okay, so I'm seeing... add an under... or, let's see. Large citadel. Sounds cool. Crash frigate. Well, I'll leave the detailed stuff to you guys in Forge. I just need good enough Forge pieces that you can use those things, frankly. Alright, so I'm gonna read through all of these right here. Let's see. Volcano, swamplands, very deep trench, canyon leading into caves, ocean cliffs, caves and ravines. Okay, so alright, so here's the three things that I also agree with that would be really good on this map. Would be caves, cliffs, and ravines. For sure, would be nice, but I'm not gonna do too much on the center of the map here. I'm gonna leave this mostly open, so if people want to make giant maps, they can. But I don't mind doing it over here, like a giant cliff side right here would be kind of nice. Let me keep going. Let me keep reading, scrolling. Deep trench, yeah. Forest, I'll leave that up to you. Large central structure, true. I like that. Demon of Song with the Fiver putting his big colorful opinions in. Thank you very much. Appreciate you. Stupidly tall plateau with a cut down the middle. Pretty flat cliffs, almost vertical. Okay. Not a bad idea. Pretty flat cliffs, almost vertical. That would be pretty nice. Giant crater. Infinitely deep trench. Desert area, cave canvas. Crater would be sick. Caves and cliffs update. Snow, ice mountain, different biomes. So, all right. For now, this is all gonna be one biome. Maybe in the future, I'll do a reskin of this map with different textures on everything. So there's like a snowy variant. Look, once it's easy to distribute maps, it would be really nice to just do a reskin of this map, a couple different ones, right? You could have just a grassy one, a snowy one, a sandy one, whatever. For now, I'm just gonna focus on the grassy version. So different biomes are not necessarily my main priority right now, but in the future, should be pretty simple to pull off, right? That being said, I have a couple ideas that I want now. I will do a canyon, I will do a cliffside facing the ocean, and that might be it. Let's see. I'll focus. Oh, right, then the silent cartographer, and then what is it? Let's see though. Let's do a little bit of investigating here, you know? Not a bad shape for a cliff. Could pull it up, make it real tall like that. But then, right, then we take a deselection brush. And we like pull it up again. Ooh. But then we like kinda, then we kinda like pull it away a third. Wait, how tall do I want that? That's already getting pretty tall. Then we go, we pull back even more, right? We pull back again, but then we pull back a little bit on this side too. And then we go, a third time. Excuse me, God bless America. What do you think? Is that gonna be a cool cliffside? I wonder if that'll be any useful at all. Make the moon your face, or it won't be good. I don't know what the fuck that means, frankly. Is this gonna be a good cliff shape? This might be a good cliff shape. I could work with this. Wait, did I not extrude straight? Oh, fuck. I could probably still work with that. Actually, that might be nice. Honestly, might be nice to have it lean a little bit. I didn't think I would like that because I wanted it to be precise, but I'll be honest, I kind of like that. All right. Excuse me. God, I'm so sorry. Like, it's so gross to, like, sniffle constantly, but, like, every time I start stream, I swear to God, I just, like, sniffle nonstop. because I'm a nerd. So basically, just gonna select these faces and get all these things moved around and smooth things out a little bit, you know? You dig? And this will make things look so much better on this map. Actually gonna be like night and day difference. Spend a little time smoothing things out, and basically once we get this smoothed out, it'll be pretty freaking nice. Also, one thing I'm gonna do today, I'm gonna do a little bit of boring stuff on stream. One of the things I'm gonna do as well though is going to be I'm gonna do a forest piece. I'm gonna do a big forest object for Forge, because I think we desperately need a giant forest piece. People have been asking for it. I know I've been thinking about it ever since I very first added trees into the mod that you could place down. And yeah, frankly, it is very much needed, so I'm gonna do that. Somehow TacoBot returned. I told you! Look, TacoBot's been playing the long con, okay? TacoBot's been trying to keep you fooled, thinking that they've been banned this whole time. But in truth, I unbanned them when I said that I did. All part of an elaborate ruse, an elaborate plot to fool you, and it's, you know, the something deep state. I don't know. Hold on, 2 seconds. We'll keep working on this cliff. Alright, sorry, it took me a second. Allergies are killing me. Whoa, Jance Fawn with the 20 bomb, holy shit! Thank you very much, Jance, that's huge! Appreciate that. Sorry, wait, I have to put everything in terms of fivers. Thank you very much, Jance Fawn, for the 4 fivers! Hey, Rejected, sorry I haven't been on many streams. I've been focused on my 3D modeling hobby with Halo stuff. Currently I'm working on making a Halo Wars 2 Cobra. It's pretty much done in modding show-off. Ooh! Nice, that's a good hobby to have, frankly. Pretty much done in modding show off. Let me poke in and see real quick. Let me see what's going on there. Ooh. Ooh, wait, yeah, you're like going hard on this. Hold on. Where's the most recent picture of it? Okay, somebody's made like cool hunters, some Halo 2 stuff. Okay. Where's the most recent one? I see turrets. Jance, please just post the most recent one to make it easy on my small brain. Please. Andrew Vendels, thank you very much for the $2. Flood outbreak. Hans, get the Flammenschwein. I think it's Flammenwerfer. Dave the Babe, thank you very much for the $2. Thank you. Appreciate that. Segment biomes would make this a real Forge world. Yeah, but as nice as that would be, it would be extremely difficult to pull off effectively, I think. I do think it would be cool, don't get me wrong. It would be, like, very nice, but it would also be quite hard. Wafner, thank you very much for the $5. Appreciate that. Make those weird cliff ramp things, like the vehicle section on the Ark in Halo 3, but larger. Weird I know what you're talking about. You're talking about when you're in the Hornets, right? Oh, Flammenschwein is Flame Hog. Oh, right, because Schwein. Yeah. I should have known that. I was reading this light novel recently, and it was they had a lot of German words in it, and I should have known that one. So, I'm gonna be honest, I think this is gonna be a little difficult to pull off and make look good, but I'm gonna spend a decent bit of time on it. This cliff could look really nice if I do it right. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take this part of the cliff here, do that, that, and that, and that. All right, and I'm gonna start yoinking, whoops. Oh my God, I'm just pressing all the buttons. I'm gonna yoink it down a bit. We're gonna pull these things down, kind of merge these together. I wanna get a kind of smooth face here. I think marshlands would be cool, so we can be Shrek and tell players to get out of me swamp. I like the way you think, and I also don't. Thanks for that suggestion. Demon of Song with the $5, thank you very much. Missing donos again, I see. Fuck. It seems you missed one for me. My bad. Did I really miss one? I was only gone for like 2 seconds. How did I miss one? I did! What the fuck? Anthony thank you for the fiber, Demon. Anthony LaMonica says that the cliff is backwards. The concave part should be facing the water due to erosion. That's actually pretty true and real. Actually, that's very true and real. That kind of like tilts me now because I like the shape of this cliff a lot because I had like a whole vision for it all of a sudden. Damn, that really does make me want to restart it, not gonna lie. Maybe I should. I'm not even that deep into it yet. What do you guys think? Kind of tempted. Still missed some donuts. Did I really? Lemon Shrink is Flame Hug. I read that. Like arc section. You're joshing me, aren't you? Wait. Oh, no. You're still joshing me. Still joshing me. I'm still scrolling. Oh, you're actually right. Bart993 with the $2. Thank you very much. Exposed Forerunner Bones. Maybe not Hexagon. I like the idea of what you mean, bones. I think I'd rather, though, frankly, give everyone those forge objects themselves and let them do it. Here's what I might do, though. For the blank canvas of this map, what I might do is have certain objects pre-placed around the map, like maybe a super carrier in the sky and like some forerunner structures around the map. But those objects, you can go over in forge mode and delete and get this to be a blank canvas if you don't like them. It just is default there. You can just delete them if you don't want them, though. Just extrude a little towards the bottom. Yeah, but I already really like the shape. If I did this like that, right? Fuck that. How far back can I undo? Can I undo enough to make it worthwhile? Oh, wait, I actually can. Nice. I can just do the inverse now. Demon with the $2, thank you. A Reach Spire. That's something I've been meaning to do for a while. A lot of people have asked me to do a Reach Spire, and frankly, I think it's a great idea. Oh yeah, you could do that like so easily, I bet. Getting green. Yeah, with the lich, that's like actual pain and suffering, but you did that like pretty easily. I mean, I think you did anyway. Look at that. Look at that. You know what, actually? Let me grab a little bit here. Like that might be nice. Just a little bit of extra cliff face. And then we'll kind of yoink it. We'll shave it. Oh, no, not that side. We shave it a little bit this way. We go, you know what I'm saying? We get that Manscaped ball trimmer action. You know what I'm saying? We get that looking pretty good. Demon, thank you for another $2. Well, people are saying Halo Wars UNSC bases as well. I wonder how well that would actually work, because those are pretty low detail, and they probably need a lot of fixing. I don't know if they'd actually be good as bases, to be honest. Worth looking into, though. Oh, now this is a shape I can get behind. This is a shape that really reminds me of the female form, you know what I mean? It really just has that nice, you know, that has that ha-ha bug to it, you know what I'm saying? God damn. Glass your wife, chill, bro, chill. Chill, we're good. God damn. Alright, let's get to work. I like this shape a lot more than you know. Main fire base would definitely be cool. Yeah, you know what, actually I've ported the Halo Wars 2 base once and it needed some fix ups, but frankly it was pretty good. Demon with another $5, thank you. Kothri says the snowbound structures as well, which might be a good reference and Easter egg referring to Arcbound. Ooh. I just realized I needed to put some Easter eggs in this map, and I need to hide them very well. And I do have some ideas on how to do it. Actually, I have some great ideas on how to hide Easter eggs, now that I think about it. Don't you just love this song? Fuck, it's so good. We should have infinite octagons. No, that's too much power. You're asking for too much. I'm afraid I won't grant you that. Now, one octagon, that's reasonable. Two octagons, pushing it, but I'll allow it. Three or more, that's just too many octagons. Just can't believe the nerve of some people. Unbelievable. Planning to add the new Mombasa roads and buildings to Ultimate Forge. Yep, 100%. It won't even be that hard, and I think people will be able to go nuts with them. So those are absolutely coming to the mod. Don't you worry. If you wanted to make a cool cityscape, I'm hopefully going to add enough pieces to make that possible. I don't want to go overboard with them and like focus too hard on them, because they are not the main focus of the mod, but they will go a long way toward making the mod have some really cool features, frankly. So, yeah. I'm like, well, I'm just gonna do one. Oh my god, I'm gonna do one layer at a time because my brain is like melting trying to do this multiple selections at once. Alright, there we go. Push you in. I go. Pew, 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 pew. Pew, pew. Ah, yep. Demon, thank you for the $5. Green Knight is now Gray Knight. Only refer to him as such. He had paid me to say this. I find that a little hard to believe, because there's some juicy, juicy drama involving somebody by that name, so. You know, I hate to say it, but. But you know what? I think that's fair. We've got Grey Knight now, and Seaman of Dong. I'm just saying. That's all I'm saying. That's, you know? Tit for tat. You dig, doggy? You dig? Bart and I. With the $5! Thank you very much. Maybe a mini Arcbound model on a table, like an architectural concept model in the airport you see in the airport lobby. I like the idea. Like, I actually do. I think it's fun. But the problem is Arcbound is just a flat plane. You know what I mean? It's like, look at this flat plane. It's a reference to a flat plane. Like, I would do it if Arcbound was more than a flat plane. But it really, that's all it was. Dude, one day I swear to God, I could do like this legendary, like tell all about like juicy Halo community drama. I think I've talked about this before. Like, I'm not gonna actually talk about it, but like, man, you would not believe in a niche community like the Halo modding community, the amount of drama that goes down is so like hilarious and entertaining. And at the end of the day, you can't help but laugh at it because it's fucking modding drama, you know? It's this niche community where people are somehow like feuding and then the tense attacks happening and the rumors and the blah, blah, blah. It's so ridiculous. It's really funny. Like, I don't know. I'm the kind of person where I just think it's fucking hilarious and like I want to grab a bucket of popcorn and like listen to it. But yeah, you would actually be like so surprised to hear about all the stories over the years. Taco Night. Yeah, Green Knight's Taco Night. Green Knight's actually, if you could refer to him as Taco Knight. Now, I know that Demon just flew in and said refer to him as Grey Knight. I mean, you can do that, but I personally am more, Taco Knight, frankly, I think. Seems like drama in modding communities is quite universal, yeah. Though I will say, Halo's community is pretty chill most of the time. You know, I feel like people are really nice and, they get along pretty well. Not always, but most of the time. It's actually, it's a good community. But I mean, you got people in that community like Green Knight. Can you believe that guy? Honestly. Green Knight? Who is, you know what I'm saying? Just unbelievable. It's just crazy. Crazy stuff. It's so funny. It's the amount of times I've seen Green get roped into drama for literally no reason, too. It just brings a tear to my eye because he has to deal with such bullshit. It's so funny. It's so fucking funny. I'm not going to talk about it too much, though. It's just funny. That's all. Demon with the $10. Thank you very much. Halo community is... All right. Oh my god, I just like ran over that so fast. Thank you very much for the $10, though, Demon. Much appreciated. The Halo community is pretty chill. Okay, then say you liked Halo 4 the best. See what happens. Okay, let me rephrase. As far as like... Because you're right. That is, you say that, people are going to be like, whoa, unbelievable. I can't believe you just said that. To clarify, the Halo modding community, relative to other modding communities, is pretty chill. And the reason I say that is because people are, like, pretty nice and get along pretty well. Nobody's out here, like, elitism or favoritism. Or at least if they are, they get shut down pretty quickly. Because that's, I hate to use this word, but it's pretty cringe. Let's be real. You're out here and you're like, oh wow, this person does things like that, or you know what I mean, like that's pretty fucking cringe. How about you, like generally, like I'll be honest, there are times when I'm just like, I get frustrated when I see people doing things a certain way, but only if they're like in the community for a long time and they should know better. Whereas like obviously sometimes people who are new to modding will they'll do things like in a newbie way, right? They just don't know. And like, why would you ever get mad about something like that, right? That's silly. Halo opinions are just bait for arguments. Yeah, it's just kind of sad that people in the Halo community argue so much over stuff. Like, chill, bro. It's not that deep. It's a video game. I love Halo probably more than most people do. I can chill about it. You can too. Demon of Song with the $5! Thank you very much. Entire map of Skyrim as a Halo map? Yeah, send me the whole 3D model, all 15 quintilobytes of it. Bring it over. Hot take, I think the 343 art style has grown on me. I like it as much as its own thing. Yeah, it's like, I think it's really cool. If it was its own thing, it would be super sick, actually. But it's not its own thing. It's Halo. And that's why, you know, everybody's like, I'm steaming mad. How could they? Which, I mean, like, to be fair, when I look at the Covenant frigates and Covenant space vehicles that are in Halo 5, like, I actually am just like, ooh, that's not okay. That's not okay. The other ones are so good. But as their own thing, like, when I look at the Phantom and the Spirit design for 5, for example, I like them. I think they look really cool as vehicles. But do I like them as Halo vehicles? Then, less so. I don't hate them, I just like them less. Demon with the $5 again! Don't tempt me, I actually have it. What the fuck? Why do you have the map of Skyrim as a 3D model on your drive? What? What? Could you explain why you have that? I'm genuinely curious. Don't you just love Halo 4 Jackals? I don't even remember what they look like at this point. Starting to like the shape of this mountain. It's going to take a bit more refining, but it's getting somewhere where I'm like, you know what? That's pretty neat. Watch this. Boom, boom, oh. Boom, boom. That's a whole cliffside now. Damn. Did he really just do that? Damn, reject the charge. He's crazy. He can't be stopped. He's out here. What the fuck? Demon with a five, or Demon with the $2. God, it's actually so often that I say Demon with a five, it actually slipped out when I read two. Thank you very much for the $2. I mod Skyrim occasionally. Ah, so you're responsible for those mods. I should have known. Should have known. Classic Demon, at it again. This is kind of a nice cliff. This is vaguely reminiscent of, like, the Covenant cliffs. Any idea when the map will go into open beta or full release? Well, there was, like, I released a quote-unquote alpha version of it. I called it alpha because it was so unfinished. But then the update to MCC recently broke it. But, yeah, I'm basically, the reason I'm doing this slightly boring stuff on stream right now is because I'm not really motivated to do it off stream at the moment, and it would be very nice to get this into working condition sooner rather than later. So I need to do this because I want the map to be like more finalized for another release. So the sooner I get the terrain looking good, the sooner I can put out another version, and I'm gonna do playtests, and you can download it and like have fun and dick around with it and all that good stuff. So that's what's going on right now. Hopefully, I can get to a point where it looks decent enough soon where I will no longer hate it. It's actually really unfortunate that the mod broke so soon after I released it. It's actually extremely unfortunate. Now I just have to kind of decide my Halo 4 Jackal dinosaurs. That's right, they look like dinosaurs. I forgot about that. Let's do boom, 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 boom. Boom. Eric Rafael Medina with the $5. Golden Among Us here in the thumbnail. Awfully bold of you. Why'd you say it like that? You're freaking me out. But yeah, you like that Golden Among Goosey. It's fucking hot. It's fucking spicy. I know. Ladies join the stream and they see the Golden Among Us, and you know, it's just over. You know, you just gotta fight them off. I'm used to it though, you know. Having been the one to put the Golden Among Us into existence. It's hard, but I manage. I do. I do my best. God bless America. This song sounded, there's like this weird instrument in the background that I swear sounded like my cat meowing, and I was like looking around like, what the fuck? Okay, what time is it? It's 7:14. This is the latest I can go to drink coffee before it starts fucking up my sleep schedule more than it's already fucked up right now. So, you know what? I think I'm gonna go pour myself another cup of coffee. I really think I need another cup of coffee, you guys. I'm gonna be honest. I just don't think I have enough coffee right now, and I just need a little bit more caffeine. Just one more hit, bro. Just honestly, just one more hit. Just a little more caffeine. So, you know, I'm gonna go do it real quick. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, look at that cliff. It's nice and thick. Hyper with another fiver. Thank you very much. I'd love to see a skewer, but it shoots a giant needle that super combines on contact. Oh, now that's interesting. Everybody's out here porting weapons from Infinite and things, and you're like, no. What if it was like its own thing? It's not the skewer. This is the Halo 3 timeline. We don't have the Banished here. We don't have the Skewer. What if it was a needle? That would be sick, actually. I really like that. It's like its own original. It's its own OC donut of steel. You know what I'm saying? I like that.
Donut steel, it's my OC, please. Please, I worked so many hard to make it. Blonic Hedgehog, so epic.
I'm listening to Sicko Mode, unironically. Green, what the fuck? That's a song. Can't listen to that song. That's a song people have opinions on. Don't you ever listen to that one. Can you believe this guy? Do you know how many people have opinions on that song and he's just listening to it? This fucking dude. Gotta get his shit figured out. I swear. This guy.
Hey, if any of you guys in chat, you know any, if there's any ladies in chat who are looking for, somebody who, makes Halo mods all day and then stays up really late, like, doing nerdy shit, like hunting down the one good anime of the season, or, like, reading a light novel until absurd hours and then promptly modding Halo for another 3 hours afterwards. I might know a guy, if you're interested in those qualities. I know, tempting, very tempting. But hey, I might know a guy. I might make this cliff part better. This has always bothered me. It's a little nasty diamond. You ever considered using sculpting tools to do this? Most terrain editors are just basic sculpting programs. Terrain. I've thought about it, frankly, but the way that Halo's terrain is designed isn't amazingly conducive to good map editors. I could do it and it make it look pretty good, but I'm trying to kind of mimic the style that Halo 3 has. We'll see. Ghost Gaming, thank you for the fiver. Oh wait, hold on, wait. I already started. Thank you very much for the fiver, Ghost Gaming. Women can't take you away from us. Don't worry, I would never abandon you for women. Would never do that to you. Theme in a song with the fiver, thank you. Joke's on you, the zip I sent, which is still loading, is full of furry models. What the fuck? How dare you? How dare you? Now you can make it so you can shoot them in game. But then I would have to port a furry model into the game. Think about that. Checkmate. Meep. Morp. With the $10. Thank you very much for the generous 10 maple syrup currency tokens. I appreciate you. You're the dream boyfriend. Also, hi. Yeah, that's me. Dream boyfriend makes Halo mods all day. It's true. No, it's true. That's actually absolutely true. What more could you want? It's missing donos again. Am I? Fuck! I didn't mean to. No, I did not. I did not. Demon with the $2. You act like you wouldn't do that. Listen, just because I imported a thick, juicy booty Cortana, and I imported a random, vaguely Halo-inspired model that had boob plates, doesn't mean that I would do furries. Right? It's different. I'm a weeb, okay? I'm a giant weeb and a degenerate, but I'm not a furry. It's different. You gotta make the distinction there. It's a very important distinction to make. Are you blending? I am. I am, in fact. Modded gamer with the $2. Landing gear is all you need in life. True. True. Now listen, don't tell my new Halo wife, who I showed off at the beginning of the stream, but I have seen some nice landing gear. Like, there are times when I pull up, you know, I see that pelican. It just arrived, you know what I mean? The pelican just arrived. It catches my eye. I see that landing gear come down. I'm like, shit, fuck, goddamn, fucking shit. Goddamn. This terrain is pretty meh at the moment, if I'm being real. It's not hitting that spice mice that I'd like. What sounds are you able to add? Any sounds, anything in the whole wide world. Since we're your favorite viewers, can we share your wife? What the fuck? What do I look like, a Wall Street Bets investor? I have a Robinhood account, and that's it. Nobody's sharing my Halo wife, okay? She's mine. All mine. Mine. You may not look at her pixels, dude. Avert your eyes from her pixels. Do not look. You may not. Her pixels are from my eyes and my eyes alone. When I look at her pixels, it's just something that no other Halo wife could have. The way that she has those sharpened vertices. The 2K textures, normal maps, that perfectly accentuate beautiful curves. No other Halo wife could match up. No other Halo wife could be imaginable compared to mine. So, don't you ever think that you could match up to her beautiful polygons
every vertice, every face map that allowed her to be imported into this game is something special that you would just never understand. What anime is this?
It's a really sad one. You'll be crying by the end. Top 10 animes that make you sad for life. Number 10, Halo Mod Tools, number 42. Demon with a fiver, thank you very much. How did you read the chat message directly under my super chat and not read the super chat? That's a good question. That's a good question. Kill it. The bots here. I will read your super chat. I frankly don't know how I missed it. You're right. I totally didn't even fuck. I don't know how I pulled that off. I don't know how I did that. Thank you for the fiver, Demon. I have anime models too. Oh, I know how. I read it in my head, but not out loud. Sometimes I just fuck up and I read shit in my head instead of. Yeah, Demon, thank you very much for the fiver. Appreciate that. I have anime models too. Also, that cat girl thing is from Doom. No. It is not from Doom, okay? It is not from Doom. You're incorrect. It's an independent modeler made it and released it. And they gave permission to port it into stuff, so I ported it into Halo. Though, frankly, I don't remember specifically where it was from. I think it might have just been like on Sketchfab or something. I don't know. I don't know. I forgot. I'm so silly. Guys, I hope you can forgive me. I know that sometimes I'm just so freaking silly. I'm not trying to be silly all the time. But I'm just such a silly guy, you know what I mean? I'm so sorry about that. It's just. Oh, what the fuck? My eyes just turned red. What was that? Oh my gosh. The fuck? My eyes turned red. I got so mad. I saw red and... Kyle from school thinks he can just talk smack about me. The fire started appearing around me on the ground, and I just my eyes went red. Fire erupted from my hands, and I said, "Kyle, you can't. You'll never take my lunch money again." Kiram Talmav, thank you for the $5 reduce. Much appreciated. Thank you. I cannot compete with the sexual appeal of a Giga Chad Halo modder. I'm gonna die alone. I'm sorry, you know, it's my fault. I gotta leave some women for the rest of the boys, you know what I mean? Not everyone can mod Halo the way that I do. I'm so sorry about that. I frankly... So terribly sorry. I'll have to do better for the boys. You know, it's real rude of me. Demon with the $2. Thank you. Second rounded cliff so there can be a canyon run. Oh, I see what you're saying. Not a bad idea, to be real. Not a bad idea. Ooh, I like the shape of that cliff, pulling it out like that. That sounded sexual. That's how you know I meant it. Gabe the Babe with the $2! Guys, women aren't even real. It's a conspiracy, Kings. I'm gonna assume you meant Kings, like you were referring to all of us boys as Kings. I like that better. That's my headcanon for how that message was meant to be read. Demon with the $2 as well, thank you. And the second one can ramp down to the flatland. Huh. I kinda like that. I was thinking about doing that somewhere else, but now that you're mentioning it here, that makes me want to do that. We'll see though. I'm gonna port this in first and then we'll see what happens. That is proper canon. Okay. Sometimes people do typos in the super chat, so I'm never like fully sure. Alright, I kind of like this. This is looking pretty spicy. I'll pull this. I gotta take this though and like yoink. There we go. There we go. God, this. I really like this. I think it looks so good. Alright, time to start marking my territory. It doesn't sound that familiar to me, but I'm here for it. It's intense. It's like, oh fuck, what's happening right now? What's going on? Rejected shotgun. He's marking seams in Blender. God, no way. He can't do that. Marking seams? Blender? God, no. God, you know what? The allergies are killing me. Give me 2 seconds. Fucking hell. I don't want to keep sniffing on Mike. It's nasty. Chance Vaughn with another $10! Thank you. Thank you very much. The video of both the lockdown and normal variant posted, I was able to keep the original textures detail and use the Halo Ward 2 textures at the same time and did upgrades. Both. Ooh. I will take a look. Please post it in modding show off so I can see. Thank you. Chat, I lit this nice moody candle for us. It's gonna be such a beautiful romantic stream today. Stop hashtag Forescreen tonight. You know I'm ignoring it. You know that I look over at chat all the time, and then I'm purposely ignoring it. It's weird. You will not Forescreen tonight. You will not. Oh. There we go. Look at that. It's beautiful. It's just beautiful, isn't it? Watch this. Mark seam. Oh my god. I just fucking marked that whole thing as a seam. God, that was so good. I love it when I mark things as seams. It just makes me so happy. Oh my god, I just marked another one as a seam. Holy shit. Did you see that? Jan's mom with another fiver on top of the other one. Thank you very much. It is posted in modding show off. Also, if you want any models for anything, I don't mind sending you the files when it's done. I will keep it in mind. All right, let me see this. You got lockdown animations and everything? Let's poke around and look at this. Check it out. This is Jance's custom Halo Wars vehicle here. Ported and edited and updated. Ooh, they look pretty damn good. I do wonder how you're gonna make it locked down though. That's an issue I've struggled with for a long time. Whew, bless God, bless America. Wow. That looks pretty damn good. Gotta get those textures colorized and stuff though. Make it green or something. That's what I always do with the Halo Wars textures. Gee. Gonna be a process and a half to get those in game, but I believe in you, Jance. It's looking good. You got this, my gamer. So you know I mean it when I say my gamer. Getting this cliff in game pretty shortly here. Promptly, we'll promptly be getting this into the game. And once it's in game, we'll get a sense for what this is gonna look like. By the way, gents, it's not gonna be easy to get those in game. But I would love to see you give it a shot, because it's frankly very difficult, and it would be very impressive to see you pull that off. I'd give you a pat on the back, and I'd say, way to go. Proud of you. This music's scary. The music's scary. Make it stop. I'm scared. Ah. Unmark these. Whoopsies. What did I just do? Alright, so I need to unmark these seams real quick. Clear seams. So this is the cliff as it is right now. And I think what I'm going to do is leave it like this for the time being. Guys. There will be no milking. I repeat, there will be no milking. There will be no milking. Stop. You're weird. Freaking people out. There will be no milking today. These seams should be relatively easy, I think. I don't know why it's giving me some weird results right now. Some of these you are. Chance Bomb with another fiver, thank you very much. No animation, since the only lockdown vehicle that really works is the blister back, so the lockdown is currently a turret, and a normal is a vehicle. Lockdown is currently a turret? Huh. Not fully sure I understand. Excuse me. Cody, thank you very much. Why did I say thank you very much? You didn't even super chat. This is my brain on coffee. Is this a forge piece or the start of a forge map? It is the forge map. This is the map. I'm adding some terrain pieces to it so that, like, there's stuff to build with, you know? Once I have these terrain pieces, it basically is, how do I put it? It's a way to have things to start with. There we go, that looks better. And do I really have to straighten it out though? Why is it like that? Whatever, it'll do for now. Yeah, long and short, that worked out pretty good. It's just a basic bit of terrain stuff that you can work off of. It's kind of nice to have this stuff, frankly. So we got a lake there, and got some stuff over here, and yeah, it looks pretty good. I think we can export this. Alright. Everything's looking pretty spicy. I would dare say this is the spicy meatball supreme. So we're gonna put this in a game. Let's see what the map looks like with the enhancements. The lake, the cliff. How does this make the map feel? How does the map feel about this? You know, we always ask, how do you feel about the map? But how does the map feel about us? Jance Vaughn, thank you for the $2. Lockdown, no move. Basically, a overpowered turret. Oh, so it's a whole separate vehicle variant that doesn't even, don't even move. That makes sense. Levels. Multi, alpine, structure. Alright, is the map explorbid? It is. It sure is. You better believe it is. Alright, so let's import it into the Vidya. Tool render, no, tool structure levels, multi alpine sandbox, structure alpine sandbox, one dot ass. Let's go, baby! Let's go! Green Knight said he has a theory. Are you saying that Milkman might be Taco Bot? Are you saying the one person who's making tons of accounts for chat might be the same person? That sounds like a conspiracy theory. Sounds like you've got some kind of conspiracy theory, and frankly, it sounds like fake news. That's what it sounds like. Yeah, because I just simply can't believe it. Green, why are you putting Java exceptions into chat? Oh, you're doing your schoolwork, aren't you? That's painful. Oh, it's writing clusters. It's writing clusters. Ah, it's writing clusters. All right, let's see. Ooh, the UVs have switched around. Oh, look, it's a cliff. It's a whole cliff. It looks okay. I'll definitely need to refine it. It's not the best. It's all right. It's meh. It'll look better once I put some more work into making it actually cliff-like, and then also it'll look a lot better once I refine the entire grid and add more detail to all of the structures. But it's a nice addition to have a little bit of terrain that's not the same as everything else. Gives Halo 1 feels, yeah, probably because it's so low detail. But don't worry, I have a whole method where I'm going to be upping the detail of every structure on the entire map. I'll do it all in one pass over a span of a couple of hours. It'll be nice, I think. And then, of course, we have our lake. Can't forget the lake. I'll need to add some beach textures and paint onto here. But let me go. What's it under? Structure. Structure painter. Is this our beach texture? I forget. Yeah, here's our beach texture. So in the future, what we'll have for the beach is this. I'll just do some smooth painting all around the edges of the beach here. Now like this. I won't be doing this painting step until much later, but it's kind of nice to see how it will look, you know? Aw, what the... Try that again. So you'd like come around here. It's grass. Then you walk over. And now it's like kind of a shiny stone. I'll need to shrink the texture so it's not so blurry and like in your face, but
yeah.
Yeah, see the beach. It's kind of a rocky beach. And this is your lake. You can build in the lake if you want. Let's see how deep I've made it. I actually don't know. Deep enough for you to go underwater. That's kind of a nice, height. So now if you wanted to, you could kind of make your own, like, maps here, like this. Did I miss a donut? I'll go back and check in 1 second. 1 second, I just wanted to place this down real quick. Let's do... rock flat large, there we go. Look at this. Now you can forge with actual water. Actual water on your maps. Probably want to do it a little bit better than I did right here, but you can do it. Actual water. Woo. Ready for some beach maps? Put your Spartan swimsuits on. Yeah, rolling. Alright, miss the note. Let's see what I had. Demon of Song with the $5! So, since you're a weeb and you like Minecraft, how do you feel about Pixelmon? I'm part of a Pixelmon server. You want in? I hate to say it, but I actually am not big into Pokemon at all. I know it might come as a surprise, but I've just never been super into Pokemon, honestly. Wait, what the fuck? Is this lighting the ground underneath? Why is it? That looks so cool. What a nice effect. But yeah, no, I actually never been super into Pokemon, so I don't actually know much beyond like the original stuff, like, you know, the OG starters. And like when I was a kid, I would watch the movies with like Mewtwo and stuff, but that was like as far as I went. I don't know much about it these days. I really was into Yu-Gi-Oh! For when I was a kid. That was really fun. Still like Yu-Gi-Oh! To be honest, I just don't play it. This is a nice lake, though. All right, let's fly. Let's see if we get vibes of the Covenant, right? I have an idea. Does this feel Covenant-y? Wait, let me paint a little bit first. I want to paint a bit more. Do vehicles. Add a Hornet. Add it to the map. Vehicles, Hornet. Boom, add you. Put it down right here. Holy shit, this is a large structure. I didn't realize how big it was. Alright, anyway, so there's our Hornet, and then let me paint a little bit, right? Just get the feel for it. Where is it? Structure Painter. God bless America. God, the allergies actually do be slapping. They do be slapping. Demon with the fiver, thank you. Hoverhog flies over the water. Also, where is the hoverhog? That's a good question. I can make the hoverhog so easily now. I can't believe I haven't done that yet. What I'm thinking, I'm crazy. Look how nice this is. By painting the moss over the edges, things look so refined. I'm gonna be so excited once I have the terrain more finalized, and then I can just do stuff like this, painting like moss to blend in with the grass a little bit, changing the rock textures around to keep things looking nice. Gonna be so good. Like, I want to do this as just a feel. I want to get a feel for things. Even though it's a super low poly terrain right now, I still want to get the feel for it, you know? So nice to paint structures. It's relaxing, you know? It really gives you a sense of pride and accomplishment with your mods. Oh, Hyper, thank you for the super chat. Appreciate you. All we need now is a water hog boat.
Do it.
I wonder how easy that would be to create, or if it would be like super hard. I think it's worth looking into. Okay, I think I got most of this painted like the right way, and then as far as the grass goes, I think stone might be nice to just paint a little bit of stone. I'll keep the opacity low. I do a little bit of painting like that around the cliff sides. Nice subtle painting to start. Doesn't look too bad. Keep it subtle, right? You do like one layer of subtle rock paint on the grass. You kind of match it up to where the cliff faces start. Like that, right? But then, you gotta wait for my secret technique here, okay? You won't believe my secret technique until you see it with your own eyes. After we do that one layer, we shrink the brush and we go over it a second time, but only closer to the rock this time. Oh, that looks terrible. Wait, what? Why does it look so awful? Let's do 25%. Yeah, it's okay. Wow, look at that painting. Look at that painting. I actually just love how it's painted. I don't know. It looks okay. That's pretty cool, all in all. Pretty neat. Yeah, I'll put a bit of grass back on that. Layer of grass to just bring that green back. Ah, whatever. It's not perfect, but it'll do. You know, I'll figure it out. I've structure painted approximately like 5 times ever. Let's see, do we get Covenant mission vibes from this? Ignore that it's low poly, okay? I know you're all thinking it. I know you're all calm down, okay? I know it's low poly. We will get there eventually. Make it higher poly. When will you drop this? Soon, I hope. Terrain's getting to a place where I'm, like, satisfied with it. Could we get a space pickle for scale? Most certainly. Most certainly you can. Alright, do we feel like we're on the Mission the Covenant where there's giant cliffs that look vaguely like this? Roblox? Alright, Hyper, that's fucked up. I can't believe you said that. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. It's okay. They're way bigger than the cliffs on the Covenant. But they kind of have that vibe to them. I'm sure somebody could work this out and do something cool with it. So you know what? I'll leave it for now. There's our lake. You know what? I need to do more with the terrain, frankly, but I'm satisfied with it for now. It'll do. It'll do. Now, there's one thing I've been really wanting to do, okay? And I've talked about this a lot. And this is gonna be like kind of sort of boring, but trust me, it's worth it. When it comes to placing down details on your map, a lot of people want to put down pine trees. Which is fair. Pine trees are good scenery objects, right? Why would you not want to put down a bunch of pine trees on your map? The problem is, okay, you have to place them down one at a time. One pine tree at a time. That's unacceptable. It would take like 20 bajillion pine trees to fill up a big map on the scale that this is. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to create the long-awaited Pine the forest piece. Can I get a big mate? We're doing the forest piece. I should have done this a long time ago. I've been meaning to do it forever. Isn't there a tree brush? No. And this is for forge anyways. So I'm gonna make the forge, the trees in forge. I gotta find out where they're under. H3, EK, Alpine Sandbox. Let me show you what I'm looking at. So I have it under... Where do I have the trees? Nature? Pine Tree Large. Alright. So here it is, the beauty and grace. This is the pine tree that has been used so many times. Demon with the $10, thank you very much. Order a Whopper meal with onion rings. So demanding, oh my god. But maybe I will. It's been a pretty good stream so far, I suppose I can. I want you guys to know that ever since I started streaming, I still haven't received the first paycheck. For when I started streaming, so. Fun fact, that's how long YouTube takes. I've received zero money so far in my life for streaming all this time. How do I want to do this, actually? If I'm going to be duplicating this a gazillion times... I know, it's YouTube takes forever to send out their money, it's crazy. See now, I could, right? I could order food. You know, maybe a nice hearty meal. Put some meat on these bones, but what if instead? Had a real meal. A real man's meal. Open it. I just bought these today. I was feeling nasty. I was feeling a real nasty beach. It's a meal for champions. That's goddamn right, remote. How do I open this? How did I open this so bad? Like, I just, like, tore it into pieces. How did I manage that? Like, I can't even get into it. I need to grab my helmet. This is terrible. Oh my god. I broke it! I broke the bag! I literally got scissors to clean. Look how clean that is. Oh my god. Incredible. Look at that cleanliness. A nice hearty meal. Incredible. Just the best. All right, how many trees should we add? Probably a lot. And how dense should it be? Use the array modifier. The array modifier is so uniform, though. It looked terrible. Copy the physics collision model and the render model. I thought about that, but. It would end up having so much merging that would have to happen, it honestly wouldn't even be worth it. I have another method, though, to save my ass in a similar way, though, so it's okay. That might be big enough for a forest piece. So these are the big trees. Particle system? Yeah, but it would take longer to set up the particle system than it would to just place these down.
Pine Tree Medium. Oh, it was a Pine Tree Medium. What? What is a Pine Tree Medium like? Alright, that's fine. Guys, I'm not using an array modifier or a particle system. I'm just not. It's gonna take too long to set up for it to be worth my time. Sometimes it's just better to do things manually. Besides, I'm not gonna let a pseudo-random algorithm decide my forest. When I could make it nice and spicy all on my own. I can fill it out. I won't leave any gaps. I get a little bit of artistic integrity. Join the Discord, and thank you. Welcome to the community, officially, I suppose. Okay, so there's our medium trees. Now let's import the small trees. Oops. Object. Entry mid. Med? There we go, that's the small ones. Good, good, good. Entry small. Whatever floats your boat, man. Hey, all I'm saying is, are you sure your way is the right way? You seem confident, but all I'm saying is, nothing's saying my way is the wrong way. I'm not saying your way is the wrong way either. They're just simply different ways. Fuck, doing that. Triangles over here. Am I gonna have to split these up into tons of different face maps? I'm going to need to, I suppose. That might be good. What do you guys think? Is that going to be good? Green did not mute Taco Bot. I don't believe it. What's your favorite piece of Halo lore? Master Chief's suit jacks him off. True. Thank you. All right. Pine Tree Large. We will save this as Forest 1. Oh, what the fuck? Hello? Forest 1. And so here's the deal. We're going to delete all the physics models and stuff. So now we got to make a physics model for the forest and a collision model. So how do we do that? Oh my god. How do we got to do that for all these trees? It's simple, and I will show you. First, we duplicate the trees and we hide the original. On our duplicate, we're going to give this the name of the collision model. So we'll have an at sign. And then, so what needs to have collision? Well, literally only the bark. Oh shit, wait. I gotta fix some stuff. Make sure that the face maps work. They do, it looks like. I gotta give them special names so that Halo knows that these are parts of the model that need to be split up. Oops. Default. What? Alright, so there we go. And then I gotta fix the... fix these stupid Citadel tree bark assign leaf A assign. Make sure that I'm not making any mistakes, so I'll just go back for a second. Leaf A assign leaf B assign and branch dead, assign. Double check that we don't have any vertices selected on any of these materials. Good, now we can delete them all. Alright, cool. Our materials are fixed. So, now we do collision models, for real this time. So to do that, it's pretty simple. The only thing that actually deserves to have collision is the bark of the tree. All the leaves do not. We delete the leaves. Bam! There's our collision models. Bullets will only ever impact the trunks of the trees. Simple as that. Now we want to do a physics model, which is also going to be similar. You only want to be able to collide with the trunks of the trees. So here's what we do. We take this. Look at all these trees. What do we do? What could we possibly do to make this into a physics model? If I tried to convex hull on it, it would do this. That would be a terrible physics model. Well, I'll show you. Using my enormous brain, we separate by loose parts. Oh my god! Unbelievable! All the trees are separate objects now, can you believe it? And then we'll clean it up by replacing .0 with nothing. And look how clean those file names are. Oh my god. And the game will automatically convex hull for us, so we don't even have to go through the effort of convex hulling all of these. Incredible! Can this man be stopped? Oh my god, the whole forest object that's already done and is incredible. Oh my god. Wow. Convex hulling, David, is where you make an object that has no concave inward-facing faces. It's a solid object. It's really easy to calculate physics for. And most of the time you only need a convex shape.
I gotta put these away. These are fucking too good.
Messy folder. Data, objects, levels, multi, alpine sandbox, forge, forest 1. Okay. I'm gonna go grab the
the shaders really quickly from Pine Tree Large. Cool, now we don't have to worry about that. Back to the data folder. And let's start importing. So we do tools, render. I'm definitely not copying all of that. All right, let's get that render model in. We'll have our forest here in a second. Whoa, duplicate triangles. Actually, where though? I'm curious, which one of these trees did I fuck up and have a duplicate of? Not the first one. Select by trait. Fuck it, I don't care. Default small has too many vertices. Okay, so I need to... Good to know. Need to grab a couple trees from the small section. Grab these four right here. Remove from this face map. Add them to this one. Boom. Problem solved. Now... we can have more detail. Let's do it again. Ooh. Demon with the fiver, thank you very much. Can you tell chat that TacoBot isn't muted? He's just not talking. Green is doing homework. He doesn't have time to mute TacoBot. That's true. Green's a busy, busy man. He doesn't have time for this TacoBot shenanigans. And he definitely did not mute TacoBot. I can check the logs right now and tell you that TacoBot is not muted. Good now? Wait, crashed? Wait, why did we crash? Cannot find... What was the crash? Why did we crash? Compute PRT? Zing PRT blocker meshes. What? Hello? What the fuck does that mean? Culture Desert, thank you for the $2. Tree damage states where they catch on fire? Catch on fire, excuse me? I don't know about that. Oh, I missed one of your super chats, Culture. I'm sorry. Thank you for the $2. I appreciate it. Thank you for your support. Go with the boneless pizza. Damn it. I really should order. Demon literally sent me $10 for a Burger King meal. And it's already 8 p.m. over here. It's late. Late as frick, man. What the frick? Hold on. Blender, select. No, I can't do a... One of these trees is a duplicate, and I don't know which one because I have so many fucking trees. Wait, maybe I can grab this and it'll... I just have to slowly, one by one, select all these little... There you are! Found you. You're mine, you sick fuck. Found that duplicate face like it was nothing. guess I have to delete my collision and physics models, don't I? That kind of sucks. Duplicate. Boom, 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 boom. And then I do a little bit of... Do a little bit of the select everything that's not a... Not a bark piece. A little bit of bone. We do a boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom. Boom. Then we separate by loose parts. Then we undo the selection. Then we fix the names. And then boom! Unstoppable! We're crazy! Oh my god, I'm actually an unstoppable force of nature. Absolutely wild. What is happening? What is happening in the chat right now? Oops. Where do I want to put this again? Here you go. Please render things out. Damn, somebody just stole my pillow. What the fuck? I just heard it. It was weird. Well, we don't have duplicates anymore, so that's good, but I'm getting a weird error. I've actually never read this error in my entire life. That's freaky. It is an error, right? Like, it's not actually building the tag. Yeah, it's not. It's saying PRT blocker meshes, beginning crash stack walk, fatal. Fatal error detected. I need to look into why it's crashing real quick. Compute PRT dot C plus, okay. So it's having trouble computing that. What if I then give it a custom PRT? I gotta give it custom PRT data then, pretty sure. I need to give it PRT instructions, I should say. Model and create. There you go. Maybe you need, all you need is PRT instructions. That would be great. Let's try again. Demon with another fiver. Thank you very much for your support. I'm reading the chat and it's making me think of Jester Milk, and I hate thinking about that. Thinking about your own milk? That sentence felt weird to say. Modware Guilty Spark is Big Mac? Wait, collision model has open at... That's unrelated, what? Why is computing the PRT failing on this? I simply... Wait, if it's compute, it's failing that, what if I just do draft lighting then? Can't I just get it in there, get things set up, and then try again? If PRT is the issue, then draft lighting should work just fine. Hey, fuck draft, or fuck BRT. Who needs that anyway? Lighting on my objects? No, it'll look disgusting and I'm gonna love it. Make sure everything has a material. I'm pretty sure it does. A new one, maybe because it's separated into so many separate objects, the PRT calculator is just like, Let's start setting it up. We can see our forest with our crappy lighting that we have on it now. Manually inserting tags. Manually. I guess we'll see how it looks. It'll probably look weird and like unlit. It won't have any of the nice shading and shadows that we find on the normal trees, because we're having issues with the shading at the moment, but let's see. Ooh. Not bad. A whole forest. Not very dense, though, to be honest. Let me fix the physics model so it doesn't bounce around. Oh, these trees have snow on them. I removed the snow on the other ones. I need to remove it on these as well. Snow and snow less should just be leaf A. Export it again. Yeah. Okay, what is going on in chat? What are we counting down for? I have been like looking out of the corner of my eye. What's happening? We're not counting down for my liver. Are you stealing my what the fuck is happening? I'm concerned. Mildly frightened. You may not steal my liver. I actually do not give you permission. I do not give you permission to steal my liver. Sorry, I don't consent, so you can't do it anymore. It's that simple. Oh, green trees, you love to see them. The Taco Bot is here! You're all fools! Taco Bot still here. LQIW, thank you very much for the fiver. God bless America. Thank you very much for the fiver. Hey, how you doing? Demon Song as well with the fiver. Thank you. Milkman was threatening to milk everyone in chat, and if Taco Bot wasn't brought back, Taco Bot is here. Milkman is Taco Bot. You're all being fooled. Who do you think is making these accounts? It's the same guy. Milkman is Taco Bot. You're being played for fools. You've fallen for the oldest trick in the book. Has taught you these lies. What do you mean? Lies? I'm lying. Guy would just go on the internet and tell lies? Whoa! LQIW with a 20 bomb! Thank you very much! God damn, that was a very generous super chat. Thank you. Nice game. Thanks, I made it myself. I need to get shading for these trees, but look, just two tree objects, and now we have this. Thank you, LQ. That is very generous of you. Appreciate it. And Demon as well with the $2. Thank you. Johnson AI driving the Corvette. That would be kind of funny, actually. Ultra strong Johnson. Okay, this is nice. I know it doesn't have shading, so it doesn't look that good right now, but three forge objects for a dense forest like this? That's what the fuck I'm talking about. Okay, not dense necessarily. We gotta add shading. We got to. Let's see I'm gonna reread the issue that the shading spits out here. I need to know, because we need shading on our trees. Frankly, the fact that we don't have shading on it is disgusting. It's gonna give us an error and it's gonna crash before it actually gives us what we're looking for here. Assertion failed. Open edges for the collision model, that's fine. Calculating PRT, 1024 rays, bounces. Error. Whoa! LQ with another 20 bomb, holy shit! Thank you very much, that's huge! God damn, you're being very generous, I appreciate that. I admire your work with this mod, thank you! Soon enough you'll be able to play a version of it for yourself. We got a decent bit of work done on the mod today, added a random cliff that needs a little bit more work, added a lake to the map so that people can build in like a watery environment. We're getting back on track with all the forge related stuff as well, so hopefully soon you'll be able to just play it and not just admire it. But thank you, I do appreciate that. It's very kind words. Oh, I forgot, some of you guys haven't seen yet. You've probably tuned in a little late to the stream, but we got condor sounds now. Listen to those condor sounds. Oh, demon with a fiber. Thank you very much. How would an AI driving the glassing game work? It would have to be set up specially. I could think of a couple ways that might work, but honestly, there's probably no real good way to do it unless it's like specially scripted to do so. Alright. There's also another sound that some of you may not have seen yet. Watch this. Let me fly the Corvette away and fly it back over. Oh, this is so nice. Green and I were messing around with this in multiplayer. We were doing a test the other day where one of us was flying the Corvette and the other was like sitting underneath it. And we were basically testing this out in multiplayer. Let me slowly bring it back over a bit more. Whoa, I'm losing control. It's so hard to control not in first person. How's the Halo 2 Scarab doing? Let me answer that right after. So spooky. That sound is so fucking spooky. The sound is fucking intense. Demon with another two as well, thank you. Gun that shoots jesters or elephants at people. That sounds horrifying and fun. I'm not sure which trumps the other. Are these sound effects from the game? Yeah, those were sound effects from Reach for that, and then these came out of Halo Wars 2. So these are the actual Condor engine sounds, in case you were curious. I just have them working together in such a way that they play kind of the way the Pelican's audio system is set up. rejected make a taco bot a moderator for your stream. No, I don't think I will. We've already been going for 2.5 hours? What the fuck? Alright, I'm confused, frankly, as to why the forest doesn't import shaded. I'll have to do some testing on it to kind of figure out specifically why. But for now, I'm just going to leave it, because technically, it works. You know what I'm saying? It works. And if it works, just works. Simple as that. But that in mind, we still got to do some more interesting stuff today. Oh, demon with the $2. Now you just need to do the condor weapons, finally. I haven't decided actually on what I want the condor's weapons to be, but I do know that obviously that it needs some. A bit tough to decide, frankly. Shading on the ground needs to be fixed as well. Corvette versus tree cluster. The tree cluster will win, I can promise you that much. Shame. I'd love to see these with shading on them. I'll have to fix it later. I do like that it has shadows, though. I just recently added shadows to the tree objects. Originally, I decided not to add shadows to any objects because the Halo 3 dynamic shadow system kind of sucks. But at least with these, I think it'll work good. With the trees, I mean. Look at that, 3 forge objects, and we got ourselves a forest. Sort of forest, you know what I mean. It'd be fun to test this on some stuff. Yeah, well, it works. Woohoo! Drivable tree cluster when? Good question. Ooh, yeah, that's kind of spooky, looking up at the Corvette through the trees. You could make some really cool maps with this stuff. Are you gonna get the Pillar of Autumn ship? Yeah, I actually already have it in a Blender file. I just haven't gotten it working in game yet. Rolling hills? There are some rolling hills over here.
Wow.
I hear you, kitty cat.
Yeah.
Here, these are the rolling hills. They're kind of big though. I might need to go back in and like adjust them. You can see they have a lot more detail than the surrounding terrain just because they're hills. A lot bigger than I would have liked, that's for sure. Okay. Wait, do the leaves on the trees not render from far away? Weird. LQ with a fiver, thank you very much. Any potential mod for the Covenant Super Carrier? Yes, I don't know how recently you tuned in, but I ported, do I have it in the map still? No, I gotta grab it real quick. I ported over a super carrier from Reach with the intent of making it a scenery, and I have another super carrier that has a giant open hangar bay in it that you can walk inside, although that one's not finished. Neither of those are drivable, but they're like super carriers I've been working on, and I was planning on adding a bunch of drivable stuff, including the super carrier, although right now it's only... Did I show this on stream? Oh, wait. Give me 10 seconds. Yeah, the Covenant Carrier from Halo 3 is a scenery object. I need to give it a physics model. And then from Halo Reach, there is the Super Carrier, which I'm importing right now. Whoa, laggy. Then let me add in vehicles. I think I showed this on stream, right? The frigate? I showed the Reach frigate, didn't I? Did I show you guys the Reach frigate on stream? I swear I did. Okay, I have to shrink it so you can actually see it. But yeah, this is the flyable... I think it's... People seem to be calling this the assault carrier, even though in Reach it's labeled as a super carrier. But yeah, assault carrier, which would be... I think if it were to scale, it would be, like, still enormous, but still smaller than the supercarrier. I don't know if it would be worth adding at this scale. Maybe I'll shrink it down to like this big. That's still so big though, holy crap. Or an assault carrier. Might be big enough, I don't know. Nobody will ever be happy with the scale, so I don't have any reason to worry about it anyway. But anyway, there's the cleaned up Reach Assault Carrier. Fix the textures a bit. Ooh, gotta fix the textures on the map a bit. And then there's also, of course, the Halo 3 Covenant Carrier. Which, there's an updated and nicer version of it in Reach that I need to port, but this is the Halo 3 one. It has less detail than the Reach one. This is the actual size it appears in 3, by the way. Hi, kitty cat. Play with my cat a little bit. I wish I had a widescreen lens, a much wider lens for my camera so you could see. Mac and cheese with beef for dinner, let's go! Alright. That looks decent, but I ain't going to use it right now. So yeah, eventually I'll do Flyable Super. That was actually one of the first mods I ever did once Halo 3 came to MCC, before there were mod tools or anything, was I even have a video on it. I made a Flyable Super Carrier on the mission The Covenant. And just like kind of dicked around with it, it was kind of fun. Excuse me. Can it drop the space pickle? Oh, you just reminded me. If somebody asked to see the space pickle up against this work in progress cliff face here. And so I have no choice now but to spawn it in. Although I think right now it's set to a nuke effect. Yeah, I think right now it's a nuke instead of a Covenant bomb. Let me double check. Yep, that's a nuke. Look at that. Demon of Song with the $2. Apparently Beth Walker now owns your channel. That's fake news. Fake news. Unbelievable. Can't believe this. Jesus Christ. LQ with a 50 bomb. God damn. You're really not playing around, are you? God. That is insanity. Thank you very much. That was a very generous super chat, LQ. I seriously appreciate that. God damn. Halo 3, in my opinion, has a better design, but damn, I really like this. Very nice work. Well, I can't take the credit for it, frankly. You know, Bungie did it. All I did was clean up the specular map so that it didn't look like it was covered in dirt, so we could actually see the beautiful texture underneath. But I do appreciate it. And this, the one that you like from Reach the Super Carrier, I mean from 3, not Reach. Where is it? I have another, like I said, there's Super Carrier, no, I'm sorry, not Super Carrier, Covenant Carrier. This one right here, the one in Reach that's used called the Long Night of Solace, is literally this model, but it's much higher detail. Yeah, it's pretty significantly higher detail. Holy shit! Demon of Song with another, with also the 50 bomb. Holy fuck! That's very generous as well. Holy fuck, thank you, Demon. You and LQ just actually slapping out of nowhere. What the hell? Another 10 fivers. True, Katrina, true. Thank you guys. That is really very generous. I appreciate that. Well, heading off. See you in VR chat. I don't think I'll be getting on tonight. I'll probably just be modding most of the night and go read and chill out, but maybe. We'll see. I'll see you around there soon, though, Demon. Have a good one. Appreciate ya. Thank you very much. Dono comp, let's go. Who could donate the most money to Rejected? Me. I'll donate money to myself. That literally doesn't make sense. Never mind. Let me put the space pickle back in. Like, seriously, though, you guys have been super generous tonight. Like, a lot of super chats coming in. I really appreciate it. All right, let's get the space pickle back up to snuff. Right now it's using the Nuke V3 effect when it gets blown up, but what we need is objects, weapons, pickle effects. Oh, there we go. There's the pickle. And it's beautiful glory. There we go. Let's go back to the pickle. Where the pickle at? Where the pickle at? Oh, it's rolling down the hill. I fucked up. Holy shit, another demon with another 50 bomb. What? Thank you very much. I don't even know what to say. That's so much. Thank you. Holy fuck. Thank you very much. I'm very generous. 50 bomb. Another 10 fivers! Much appreciated, demon. Holy fuck. Also, just so you know, I bought your channel off of Beth Walker so I could give it back to you. Oh, of course. I forgot about the hostile takeover that happened in chat earlier. I appreciate you doing that for me. Who knows what kind of weird stuff Beth might have been up to on my channel. Thank you. Thank you very much for saving me. Appreciate that. That was ridiculous though. Thank you very much. Oh. Cubby Nuke's kind of small. Oh, I crashed it. Nope. Yep. Fuck. Excuse me. That is ridiculous, though. Thank you, guys. I literally can't get over that. Like, I try to play it off, but that's so much. Ridiculous. How the hell you get a pickle and a nuke mixed up? No. It's the space pickle. It's different. It's not just a pickle. It's a space pickle. It's completely different. Completely different. I'll show you. Will you make destruction animations for the ships? I'd like to. I'm focusing on one ship at a time. Right now the Corvette is my main thing. Although... Oh, I completely forgot to show the frigate. The frigat, if you will. My bad, forgive my ignorance. That's fine. I completely understand. It's totally fine. Demon with the two dogs, thank you. Much appreciated. And LOL and the Nilo Monica. What the scrolling. I propose that you make a custom frigate for Demon to help carry his jester around. Wait, does the current frigate not carry it around? I feel like it should. Maybe it's too shallow. Oh, you know what? It might need to be scaled up like 1.5 times to be able to hold it. Beth, please, do not spam. Do not spam the same message over and over. I will have to do the same rule I use for everybody else who spams messages over and over on you. And I would prefer not to, because it's not a fun thing. Alright, we're gonna add... We did this on stream, if I'm not mistaken. We did do the frigate on stream. Okay, I swear we did. Ah, it's beautiful. The Halo Reach frigate with some Halo 3 textures applied to it, or like Halo 3 shaders. Will the frigate shoot? Yeah, eventually I'm gonna give it a mat cannon. It's gonna be sick. The right size to go up against a Corvette, it's only slightly smaller. Woo! I really like the Reach Frigate design so much better than the Halo 3 one. I hate to say it, but it's so much nicer. LQ, thank you for another fiver. Appreciate the support. How long until you feel like this is ready to be released? So the actual final release of it, where like I'm actually satisfied with it and has all the content that I want, won't be for a while, because I plan on adding a bit more to it, more forge objects, AI, and like more vehicles and a lot more weapons. But I have been I released an alpha version of this. It was alpha 0.3 a little while ago. MCC update came out and broke it, so if you try to launch it, it'll give you like a weird colorful screen. Because everything's busted, but I'll be releasing an alpha 0.4 pretty soon. That's why I was working on the terrain today, because even though I want to work on more fun stuff, I need to get the new terrain finalized more, that way I can get 0.4 out sooner rather than later. So that's, I would say, as for an actual time, I don't like to commit to actual times because I never make them, but I would say not that long. Actually, not that long. Let me think. I haven't really thought about specifically how long it will take. The map terrain, I can release an unfinished map terrain, that's really no biggie. As far as vehicles go, the Corvette's decent, it'll be fun for like mini games and such. The frigate could be in, the drop pod's already in. Honestly, I could release it in the next couple of days. I think the Mantis, I had patched it so that it doesn't have the damage issues, the Locust works as well. The drop pod is in, like I said, the Corvette is in, and I just gotta do some fixes on the effects for the Corvette until it looks good. And then, basically, it's just a matter of, do I feel good about releasing a crappier version of the terrain on 0.4? Which, yeah, I could live with that. So yeah, maybe a couple days. That's the answer. Kinda needed to work through that mentally for my own sake, too, but closer than I thought. I would've said a week originally, but now that I actually thought about it, yeah, a couple of days. Beth, I'm gonna have to mute you if you keep spamming all caps demands. It's not a good look, to be honest with you. Will it have AI? Yeah, that's the plan anyway. It will, in fact, have AI. The Reach Frigate's so sexy. Reach Frigate with the Halo 3, like, Greeble stuff on it, making it the dark and oh, it's so good, it's so good. I would really like to add a Mac cannon onto this. Maybe I'll add a Mac cannon onto this, like. Maybe I'll do it off stream. I would do it on stream, but frankly, there's more important matters to get to while I'm on stream. Wait, what is that? I wonder. Hey, Rez, good to see you. Good to see you, Stratticus. Needs the kablammy cannon. I want to get the sound effects from Reach. They sound so cool for the Mac cannon. Maybe from Halo Wars 2 if they sound better. Green! Ding dong! Green! Do the Halo Reach Mac Cannon sounds cooler, or the Halo Wars 2 Mac Cannon sounds? Are they, like, which one sounds cooler? Are you here? Have you made a 400 Q ship flyable? I have not, Drew, I have not. But it would be cool to. Oh, I gotta get the better effects. These frigate effects, they suck. The ones that are actually in Reach are so cool. These are the Halo 3 frigate effects. Man, I gotta do. I literally sent you the Mac Cannon sounds the other day. But aren't those the Condor sounds? Or is the Condor the only one that has a Mac cannon on it in Halo Wars 2? I forget. Hyper with the $2. Thank you. Ah, the UNSC frick it. True. That's pretty true and real. Infinite sounds good. Wait, Infinite has a Mac cannon? And the Condor Mac cannon sounds. I gotta listen to them. In fact, I think I will listen to them. I gotta find out where you sent them, though. Because I simply do not know, don't remember. I'll look at it later, frankly. Some engines ain't even firing, are they? Oh yeah, the little ones aren't. Yeah, because I didn't even set up these engines. It wasn't even supposed to have engine effects. They just auto-applied because I used the effects from the Halo 3 frigate. And the engine markers were named the same thing in Reach, funnily enough.
Are you going to put space debris in the sky? I'll leave that for you guys to put it in Forge, frankly. I'll put some destroyed chunks of space debris up there so you can just mess around with them.
Oy. God, I am tired today. I mean, we've only been streaming for 3 hours, but I feel so exhausted. I think maybe I should have ordered that Big Mac after all. I think I just need a goal here. We got the map looking pretty good, and I'm pretty psyched about that, to be honest. The water looks pretty nice. You'd love to see it. Not perfect, but I like it nonetheless. I'll need to do some painting to make this water in the lake area at least a lot more subtle. Right now it's like ocean waves, so they look kind of weird against the shore, but I can actually paint it to be downwards a bit less. Brains! Thank you very much for the fiver! Much appreciated. Map is looking awesome. Will we have more detail pieces for the next release? Crates, barrels, etc. Also need some anti-air like ODST turrets, missile pod turrets. The ODST turrets would be nice to bring back. I like those a lot. I think what I'll do is I'll make a whole vehicle tag for the ODST turrets. Should work pretty good. I think I know how to fix the issues I used to have with the ODST turrets and to make them forgeable, so that'll be fun and nice to have working. As for more detail pieces, crates and barrels, I suppose I could add them. I didn't really focus on it too hard just because of the more priority being like bigger objects, but I could add more, yeah. There's space on the forge list for it right now. And LQ, thank you for the $5 as well. I joined Discord, too, so I can't wait to see that. How does the Nexus mod work with modding Halo? Oh, you just... that's just where people upload the files. You don't really have to do anything special with Nexus mods. You just download the maps and, like, plop them into your Halo folder. Nexus is literally just a place to host mods and download them. Check. I need to take a look around. I redid the glassing beam weapon recently. Glassing beam. Where are you going? Corvette.
Excuse me.
Oh, yeah. Multiplayer. Yeah. New one right here. The glassing beam never gets old. Yeah, right? Me when a spider in my house appears. That was me last night, actually. I was laying in bed, was watching a show, relaxing, slowly falling asleep, and I see a spider just slowly descending from the ceiling on the foot of my bed, and I was just like, what the fuck? Where did that come from? I literally moved from Washington State, where it was so cold all year round that I never saw any bugs, to now seeing spiders and shit in my bedroom. Unacceptable. Unacceptable. I will scream and cry. A lot. But fires from here. Effect for firing. Is this? Why it's no appear at the right spot. Hey, Rejected, are you gonna add AI Spartans in this mod? I don't know, I didn't really thought about it, to be honest. Maybe. I was planning mostly just doing, like, Covey AI. Because all the AI should be enemies anyway, because you can't pick teams in multiplayer. Projectile fires from weapon origin, does that fix it? I don't know why the effects aren't coming out of the right spot here, it's really weird. Damn, we both moved from Washington to Texas. Why is it? Hold on. Glassing beam is fire. The effects and stuff are on the wrong location. That's weird. I'll have to do some testing off stream to fix that. It's kind of bothering me though. Get off the cliff over here. By the way, this mod, one of the things that makes me want to complete it really bad right now is that Green and I were testing this in multiplayer the other day. We were messing around with, like, drop pods, flying all the way up into space and stuff, and messing around with the ships and all the vehicles, and it was really fun. So I think it's just, like, really motivated me. It's like I realized, like, yeah, this mod is actually a ton of fun just to mess around with. Like, not even playing the custom game modes that can be made with this, but just playing in Forge with a friend on this is like a fantastic time. So I really want to get it out so people can have as much fun with it. It's like, have you ever played Gary's mod? This mod feels a lot like Gary's mod. You just have this massive list of crazy stuff that you can spawn in, and it's a lot of fun to mess with. And that's it feels like you're on like GM Flatgrass on Gary's mod, if you know the feel, and you just have like tons of stuff to mess with. The fact that I kind of captured a bit of that feeling in this mod makes me really happy, because that's like one of my favorite things in the world. It feels like Gmod with a bunch of Halo add-ons. But it's actually in Halo, which is crazy. What's the mod's file size? Not that big, actually. You'd be surprised. It's like, I think, I don't know, because I just imported the thing that reduces the file size a lot. I'd have to build the map now and find out for sure. But it shouldn't be like more than like 400 megabytes, 500 megabytes. What's the IRL scale of this map? Very big. That's all I can tell you, is that it is very big. Oh, God, I don't know. I'm just so freaking tired today. It's so weird. I think I might head off earlier than usual, just so that I can, like, go get some rest. I'm gonna do it. Yesterday I took a bath for the first time in, like, years. I never take baths. I'm a rugged mountain man. I only take showers, and I let the rain cleanse me while I'm chopping wood in the forest. So taking a bath for the first time was nice. Just do that, relax, and exist for a little while. I'm just tired as hell. What's the range of the glassing beam? Can you glass from space? Yeah, it has like infinite range. I can show you what it looks like to glass all the way from space. I think all I'd have to do for that is go into this mode here, look up, backspace, bind pin control, and then just fly straight up. Or wait, no, I take that back. I do like that. Game speed 10. I gotta walk all the way over there. My Spartan will eventually get into that Corvette. I have game speed multiplied by, there we go. Game speed is super high. All right, you wanna know what it looks like to glass from space? Crap. Well, I won't be able to get that thing out of the way, but there you go. It does not travel instantly. It is a physical plasma projectile. The game had speed of sound delay. I know. I tried to mimic that with the nuke. Yeah, there's a delay on the sound, but it's a fixed delay. The slowness adds to the girth effect. I know, right? It's got that heaviness to it. I literally could sit here and watch this thing glass all day. True and real. Oh god, I actually turned into it. It was funny, I was playing with Green, and he had like gone all the way up into space way higher than this, and he had like set up drop pods and stuff, and he was like, you gotta come up here, and I just like took the frigate and I slowly like flew all the way up into space. He's like, where are you? And I was like, look over the edge, and I just like had the frigate appear and like slide on up. I think he actually posted it in Twitter. It was kind of a cool moment. Or not on Twitter, in Discord. Let me open it up. Oh yeah, right here. He didn't record the audio, so you couldn't hear us talking, but here. It's literally, he built this little platform up here, and he's like, hey, come up here, let's drop in the drop pods together. And I was just like, don't worry, I'm almost there. Just appeared in a giant frigate. It's so much fun to mess around with this mod, it really is. Alright, I think, I've been having a lot of fun this stream, but I'm honestly so powerful, you just read somebody's chat, I'm really tired, and I think I'm gonna call it quits early today, and then just make up for it by streaming earlier tomorrow and going longer, because frankly, I don't know why I'm so tired, I just feel physically exhausted. We can just mess around with it right now, to be honest. I agree. Let's do it tomorrow, though, Green. Like, let's make a promise to do it tomorrow, because I'm actually so tired that I just, like, want to go relax, eat some dinner, and just like, dip out of existence for the night. I don't know why. I'm super tired, but hey, I guess it's good. I've been, my sleep schedule's been poo, so I guess being tired at this hour is a good thing. I need to see that drop pod. Ah, when you put it like that. I suppose we could do one drop in the drop pod. Just one drop, please. Just one drop in the drop pod is all I want. Please, sir, please. Then we gotta add the crate object. I think it's already in the map. What is it? Crate object of... the pod clamp. We'll take the pod clamp and we'll put it all the way up to 900. No, wait, 700. Yeah, 700 is the right number, I think. Actually, how high can it go? Oh, what? That's nothing. I could go way higher than that. I think Green and I had it up to like here at like, what, like 1400? Yeah, we had it really high up here, 1500 units up. It was ridiculous. Let's see, negative 16, negative 109, 1500. There we go. Takes a minute, but eventually you can get the pod in there. Save, refresh. And we don't crash. You love it when we don't crash. All right. Here goes nothing. It's going to be really fun. I know that obviously the new update, when this comes out in 0.4, and hopefully a couple of days, we'll have the drop pods. You guys will get to have a lot of fun messing around with this thing, probably discovering bugs and stuff. But I tested it in multiplayer and it synced just fine. Door came off, all the animations played. It was great.
Yay!
There you go. Literally can't see where we dropped from. It's actually so high up above the clouds. But there we go. That's the drop pod. That's gonna be it for me though. So exhausted today. But thank you guys. Thank you very much. There have been some extremely generous people today with some extremely generous super chats. You know who you are. All of you who generously supported me today, I genuinely appreciate you from the bottom of my heart. You make this possible, and I thank you very much. Everybody in chat today, thank you for being here and participating in this shorter stream. Tell your friends, tell your family, reject the shotgun, make mods. But seriously, thank you. I got some videos cooking up on a lot of this content. You know, a lot of people don't watch the streams, but they'll watch some vids, so I'll have that coming out soon. Join the Discord server if you want to stay part of the community, even off stream. Follow me on Twitter if you want to see some behind the scenes stuff. And tomorrow I should have a YouTube membership set up, so there'll be some cool perks. I'll talk about that later tomorrow. But yeah, that's all for today. I'm gonna go relax for a little bit. I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your night and or day. And I'll see you tomorrow, a little bit earlier, for a little bit of an earlier stream. Thank you very much for being here, and I'll see you then. Bye-bye.